Morning guys, Darren at Green Pro Clean Limited here, window cleaning in Nottingham and Derbyshire. Question I've been asked before is about doors, how to clean and restore a uPVC door. And if I can ask Andrew to step in a bit, we can look at what's wrong with this. We can see plenty of scratch marks up in here, some algae where it's never been cleaned in a long time, plenty of scuff marks where it's been opened in with a boot instead of using the handle, and some general various bits of dirt, yellowing and scuffs. So to deal with this, quite simply, I'm going to get down on my knees and pray. No, I'm kidding, I'm not going to start praying. Well, I'm just going to pray that the video works out well. But all we're going to do is we've got our bucket of soapy water. Nothing special in here, this is fairy liquid as usual, and we're only going to work on this little section here to give you a gist of what we do with the whole door. We start at the top. Don't do that. I did that deliberately to show you what not to do. Always make sure the door is properly closed, so otherwise you'll be flooding the customer's house. Now this is how to do it with a traditional door restoration. We get right in the top of all these gaps first. And why? Because, well, crap sits on the top ledges. So as we get in here, we start to notice a lot of this is coming off quite easily, including the green algae that was just there. I'm using nothing more than the pound roll scourers as usual, and or pound land. I forget which one's gone bankrupt, but there'll still be one about near you. Or pick them up at your Sunday market. So always take off the surface crap first. And the reason for taking the surface crap off is otherwise all you're doing is rubbing the surface crap up and down on your surface and potentially causing more damage. So we're not going to go too deep into washing this with a sponge because that'll just bore you guys, I know. But now we've got that wetted up, let me dip into my pockets here, find a rag. As I mentioned in a previous video, always have your pockets ready on your tool belt so you can keep all your bits and pieces in there. I'm going to give this a wipe along, just take off most of the moisture there. And we can still see the scuffs and the scratches, but it's already looking whiter down there just because it's becoming clean. And it hasn't been cleaned in a long time. And I know this because, well, once again, it's my back door, so I'm almost embarrassed by this. But not so much that I won't do the video. So what are we going to do? Of course, we're going to do the UNGER RUB OUT. 15 quid a bottle from your suppliers, and people always ask, and I say to them, oh, what's cheaper to rub out? If you're that tight, then go to a different industry, honestly, because the reason I've decanted it into my little bottle is I've said this before, I don't like customers knowing what I'm using. I want them to hire me, not to go, oh, I could get a bottle of that off the internet and do it myself. But the thing about rub out is all you need, you think it's expensive, but all you need is a dollop. A dollop like this, and we're going to tackle this section here, Andy, if you get down a little bit, and we're going to start rubbing. And as we start rubbing along here, I'll even get in under that brickwork so I don't need to come back and do this later, so the wife doesn't say, you missed a bit, but which she often does. And we just keep working it in and working it in with the rub out. Now remember, this is all being done by hand. There are some lads out there who will actually machine polish UPVC. Like you would with a car paintwork, and but for me, I'm not quite there yet. I don't want to be machine polishing. I want to do it all best I can with my hand tools. And we've come along here with the first pass. And let me just find a drier rag. There we go. I'm going to take out that, and you can already see how much of a difference we're starting to make. The abrasions are disappearing. The top surface crud is disappearing, and so on. So we're going to come back with another dollop. The sponge is always wet. Don't use the rub out dry on a sponge. Don't use the rub out on a dry sponge, I should say, because it will take a lot more to work it in. If you use it on a wet sponge like so, it just goes further and it's so much easier to work in. And we keep working it down along this bottom lip here to get out those abrasions. And here we go. Now for these ones. And it's elbow grease, elbow grease, elbow grease. I may be a fat boy, but I've got a right bicep like Popeye, mate, I tell you, from all this UNGER RUB OUT. And that's all it comes down to. Here we go. We're starting to take that off. And as you can see, this one here, how to tell, this little scratch here, this one's never coming out. Because if you run your nail over it, just like on car paintwork, if you can feel it, it's not going to come out. But we've got all of the dirt marks off, all of the scuff marks off, and we can see the difference coming up already. We're just going to tackle this corner a little bit here to give you an idea of the difference that can be achieved once again. Using nothing more than soapy water. So I picked up a random hair from somewhere, get rid of that. Using nothing but soapy water, a scouring pad, and a little dollop of UNGER RUB OUT. Now I know I've said the word UNGER RUB OUT about 15 times in this video, but I can't stress it enough. When I say it is the bee's knees, it really is the bee's knees.
and you'll notice these scratch marks, these scuff marks, the dirt. I've lived here for a year and a half in this house now. I've never once cleaned this door, and it's not been cleaned for a few years before those people before me. So let's see what we can do with this. So here we go. Just pop that in my bucket. We'll take the rag, and I'm sure the camera's going to pick this up now. But as you can see that this looked like that just 10 seconds ago. And you can see exactly how good this stuff is. If you're still not convinced, you're never going to be. Along the top here, Andy, I hope you can pick this up, there's some more scratches and ingrained gouges that if you can feel it with the nail, they're never coming off. So don't keep putting your time into what you can feel. So there's that to there. Now, I don't know what that is. I think it might be a boot mark, actually. So a bit more soapy water. But just to show how it tackles everything. Somebody pulling up at the drive there. But I'll get to them in a minute. As you can see, even that is starting to come out. Looked like it was stained in there, but it's starting to come out lovely now. We'll go right the way up and do this piece of the panel. And there's various scratches and scuff marks, but just that one tiny dollop, once again, I know I harp on about being pea-sized, but that really is your need, all you need, I should say, to do a large area. And keep rubbing next, there's a little yellow mark there. That's gonna annoy me if I leave it. And once we've been over there, now, to do a full door like this, I would spend an hour on it quite easily, and I would happily charge £40-45 per door to do a door restore like this. And as we can see now, that yellow mark is still a little bit there. I can still see it. I don't know if the camera's picking it up, but once again, I'm just going to go over it again, and that will finally get rid of that. But once again, when you get down, I'm sorry, Andy, I know you just stood up. I'll ask you to come back down once more. But well, you can see the scratches here, that's what it looked like. And we will, I'll get Andy to wait there for 1 second, just to show very quickly how good this stuff is. First time our Andy here used this stuff, he said, holy shit, or words to that effect. I would ask him to talk to you guys, but he's camera shy. So, hearing giggling in the background. He's not the kind of prima donna you'd find as frontman for a rock band. There we go, guys. You can see the huge difference already. Those scratches, those scrapes have come out of here just beautifully. And that's UNGER RUB OUT for you. Order it off eBay, order it off the internet. Mine usually comes from the cleaning warehouse in Wolverhampton. And one bottle it is. You could do 20 doors quite easily, but just keep your portions. Pea-sized dollop, that's it. Pea-sized, do that. Pea-sized, do that. 4 or 5 little pea-sized dollops, you could probably do this entire bloody door. So I hope you found this useful. If you like what we do, please subscribe. Comments in the boxes below as always, guys. Apart from that, thanks for watching and have a great day.